UFOs have made all sorts of headlines this week. So today, Michael Grace took a look at when they were reported in the skies across Texoma.
UAPs are unexplained, it's true, but they are real. They need to be investigated.
Well, that was Indiana Representative Andre Carson talking about unidentified aerial phenomena, or as most of us know, UFOs. In case you missed it, on Tuesday, Congress held a hearing about UFOs as the number of reports for UFO encounters continues to grow. This is the first hearing of its kind in more than 50 years, which led me to the question, have you ever seen any UFOs here in Texoma? The answer is yes. Now, these reports come from the National UFO Reporting Center online database. Since 1989, there's been 37 reports here in Wichita Falls. And why some may be things like satellites, there are others that stick out. In a 1995 report, it states that they saw a green light that made impossible movements in the sky, then darted away. In Iowa Park, there's been three since 2007, where somebody reported a blinding pink light. And in Electra, there was a craft with a bright, clear light illuminating from, quote, portholes hovering over a field near a house. That was in 2004. Now, in Vernon, only two reports since 1965, but the 1965 report stated that there was an orange and red light that defied the laws of physics. Go over to Nakona and Bowie, only one since 1997 in Nakona, two since 2006 in Bowie were reports of a craft going faster than a jet. And while these were still all reports for now, with congressional hearings getting the ball rolling, it's always interesting to think, what could be out there? Ashley, back to you.
Thank you, Michael. Last year, the U.S. Director of National Intelligence released a report that found 144 unexplained encounters from 2004 to 2021. Since then, it's gone up to approximately 400.
And I, for one, do believe that we are not alone.
The News Channel 16 did a pretty good job with this report on UAP UFOs in the area of Wichita Falls and Texoma. I would point out that one sighting from July of 1952, classified as unknown in Project Blue Book, was omitted from their report. This may be because the Air Force suggested a possible, if unlikely, explanation. More than a few of those cases should be reexamined.
Wichita lineman is still on the